we're setting up for this next number, I'll just take a couple of minutes and talk to you about it for a little bit. I'm assuming that all of you have some degree of familiarity with Messiah. This is actually one of the few works in Western music that never lacked popularity or frequent performances. Usually, even a great masterpiece is sometimes, as you're well aware, totally ignored at first, or it might have a big, huge gala premiere and then be completely forgotten for 100 or more years. That was not the case with Messiah, which was actually performed by a less than professional group, tiny little group, about 20 singers, and an orchestra of about 16, which is a far cry from the mammoth performances you see today. It was premiered in London in a tavern. Taverns were very different than they are now back then. But it was premiered in a tavern called the Crown and Anchor. And when word got out, a clergyman who signed his name to a pamphlet as Philalethes, and I don't think they've ever figured out exactly who it was, demanded that the performance be boycotted and that Handel and all of his crowd be rounded up and put to the Inquisition because, quote, should the words of the Lord be sung in the mouths of actors and other degenerate sorts? Well, his opinion didn't take hold very well, and it wasn't too long before movements of Messiah were being extracted for use in worship services. And any of you here are churchgoers, you have heard, especially at this time of year, one or two movements used during the course of the service. Anyway, we're going to perform three sections for you. The first two are from the Old Testament section of Messiah, the Advent and pre-Christmas section, which is appropriate for this time of year. And the third movement is Hallelujah, which is not appropriate for this time of year, but if you do sections of the Messiah, you've got to do the Hallelujah chorus. So here are three movements from Handel's Messiah.